are you doing?
I know you want to go out.
I know it's what you want.
Having the underfloor heating on in August, which I'm not impressed with overall, but he loves sleeping on the kitchen floor now and looking outside in the outside world, which soon you'll venture into again. Bless him. What'd you say? Oh, where are you going? What have you seen? Oh God, it creeps me out when they do stuff like that. What are you looking at? There's nothing there. Yeah, it's extremely creepy, Weege. Don't do that to me. Let's make a coffee. Some of the bathroom stuff started arriving. Very exciting. Just listening to Wolf Alice. Still one of my favourite albums of the year. So with the bathroom, with anything house, I will make it clear if something's been sent to me or I'm being like working with a brand on something or if I pay for it myself. Just resting you on some rickety old drawers because we like to live life on the edge sometimes. So these are some tiles, some sample tiles, which have been sent to me. And they are from the Yorkshire Tile Company, which obviously was very excited when they messaged me and said that they would like to help in some way with bathroom. So yeah, I'll just make it clear as we go what I am paying for, what if I'm working with a brand on a sponsored post, whatever, as always, make it clear. They also sent some little Yorkshire treats with it, some chocolate from a Yorkshire chocolate company, some tea, and obviously the ultimate tea. Anyway, so because I'm having glass bricks in the bathroom along the hallway wall, the size of the tiles is somewhat dictated by them in that you kind of want it to be a multiple of the size of the glass brick so that it doesn't look too bad. So we have a large tile here, which I actually don't think I'm going to go for. I think I'm going to go for a smaller tile. And then I have three smaller tiles, all in just off-white, which is sort of perfect because it will soften the whole look of it a little bit. I'm just going to go for grey grouting because white is obviously just going to get gross so quickly, high maintenance, and black I think might look dated quite quickly. I just not really for me. Let me show you properly. So these are the, in fact, let's take them into the kitchen where the lighting is a bit better. Hello, sir. Well. Fancy seeing you here. Well, you always are. The kitchen meowing at me. Which one do you like, Weege? Can you help me pick? I mean, very similar and slightly different sizes, as you can see. This is the one that I am drawn to the most, I believe. Do you like this one too? This one seems like the most kind of pure white one, but this I think is going to look really nice. I would go and put it in the bathroom, but obviously there's actually no way of judging what the light is actually going to be like in there. But I mean, really simple. I like the fact it's slightly textured. I kind of want it to feel, you know, I don't want it to feel super modern, basically. I want it to be minimal, but to sort of have the feeling of, you know, like when you're in Europe and you just go into a really nice bathroom and a really nice hotel and everything's simple, but has a slightly aged look to it, really classic. That, and I think having a slight bit of texture on the tile like this will really add to that, as opposed to them being like really flat metro tiles. So this looks lovely. The radiator arrived this morning, which we can unpack together. I just need to try and get it up the stairs, which is probably going to be the death of me. But yeah, I'm really, really just, it's so nice to work with a Yorkshire-based company as well on something like this. So I will link Yorkshire Tiles in the description box. And hello. What are you doing? The underfloor heating is on and he obviously couldn't be happy about it. He loves it. but yeah, big thank you. Just working at home all day. I've had such a lot of time at home recently, which has been really nice, but work is so busy, which is also great. So I've just got calls all day today and then going to the pub later for a couple of drinks. I'm like madly into Guinness at the moment. It's really like really weird. Just obsessed with having a Guinness, and obviously you can get a Guinness out of a can, but it's just not the same. So I keep having to go to the pub, dragging people to the pub with me so I can have a pint of Guinness. So I'm going to the pub tonight with the girls, which is really nice. Have a pint of Guinness and some food. And until then, we are just working away. I'm going to show you the Arquette bits next. I've just got a call now in 15 minutes about a really exciting project, actually. And then I shall show you the Arquette bits after this call. Having a small battle with the sunlight in here, which I'm losing, very much so. Turns out I can't conquer the elements. Shock. Arquette, coming at you. This video is sponsored by Arquette. These are the pieces that I picked up from Arquette last week when I went into the shop IRL, as they say, which I enjoyed. Actually, I've got a couple of men's jumpers here, and when you go into the shop in real life, it's sort of easier to pick out the men's pieces that you can try them on, and the sizing is weird. Anyway, well, not weird, but it's harder to judge with men's. And I'm here to tell you that I recommend going for a small in the men's pieces, like this jumper, which is a men's small cashmere black jumper. Really simple, really classic, but honestly, this is just the kind of piece I'll wear to death. I have many a cashmere jumper, I'm aware of that, but they all get worn all of the time, they all get washed all the time. I still have the ones from many years ago, and I still believe I have room for more, if I'm honest. This is a men's small, it's really simple, it's really soft, it's got a really nice loose fit to it. Quite a wide neckline, I would note, but not a bad thing at all. Nice long in the sleeves, really great. You'll wear this all the time. Big thumbs up. The shorts. Up until 10 minutes ago, wearing shorts seemed insane, but now it's suddenly hotter than the sun in this room. These are some nylon shorts, which wasn't something I ever thought I needed until I did a shoot a while back and Prada loaned me some stuff, which is mad. And one of the pieces they sent was a pair of nylon shorts, and it really opened my eyes to them. So here we are. These are from the women's section. They are small. They have zippy pockets, which I really like. Show you, zip zip. I mean, you all know what a zip is, but just on the off chance you didn't. They're really great. I kind of wish I got medium, if I'm honest. They basically could be a bit longer and even baggier, but they are nice and wide on the leg, but not too wide. I think it's a really flattering width over the leg. Nice elasticated waistband, which we love. Yeah, I just could have had them a tiny bit longer, if anything, but that's just because I'm not a fan of short, really. Really nice straight fit, though, as you can see. They're really good. And I really like the nylon texture, which is good because that's what they are, in the fact that it's really nice with like knitwear and even just a cotton t-shirt. Bit of a different texture for me. Don't really wear very much nylon. But they look great with knits. I'm just going to show you it with another knit really quickly. This one's also... from the men's department of Arquette. This one I put a photo on Instagram yesterday wearing it, and my gosh, I've got so many questions about it, I couldn't believe it. Just goes to show that we were all believing that a navy blue jumper honestly is the gift that keeps on giving. This is a small as well, much chunkier. It's covered in cat hair, so don't judge me. I've been wearing it every single day since I got it, which is a week now of constant wear. It really needs a wash, which I will do later. But Luigi is molting like mad. Insane amounts. He's never molted this much before. So it's covered in cat hair, so please no judgment for that. But you can see it's kind of like a chunkier knit texture. I love this knit. This is a wool one. It's not cashmere. A wool jumper. They do it in a few different colours. But honestly, I love this so much. So easy to just throw on. I just know how much I wear navy blue jumpers, honestly. I actually prefer them to black jumpers. If you're in a one or the other scenario, I'd go with the navy blue. It's just great. Like, it's just so boxy. It's great. Great, great, great. I'm going to slip my jeans on. These aren't Arquette, but these are just some really old jeans, just so that you can see what this looks like with some denim. Okay. Yeah, these are really old. Actually, they're from Topshop, these jeans. Many moons ago. But yeah, you can kind of see a bit better when it's not against the black shorts. Really, really pleased with it. Right, I've got one more jumper to show you. Okay, we've got one from the ladies department here. This is a tight ribbed black one. It's long in the body, which I don't have an opinion on either way, but it kind of felt worth mentioning because it feels longer than average. I'm going to tuck it in for this demonstration. Obviously, the winning factor of this was the really nice neckline, which is super different. I actually think this is going to look nicer with my hair up. So I'm going to put my hair up. Yeah, this is just kind of a nice fancy jumper. Fancier than usual jumper. Let me get a hair clip. Okay, I've just very roughly put my hair up, but you're going to get the gist of it more because I think it's really nice having it up with a neckline like this. I'm just moving into the shadows because hopefully the lighting's going to be a bit better. Yeah, so nice. It is really nice and long in the sleeves. I haven't got a jumper that's a neckline like this. It's just something really flattering about it and a really like easy piece to put on but feel a bit more evening ready. There's something really fancy about it, and it is definitely the fact it's really nice slim fitting. Love how long the sleeves are. It's like quite a thick rib to it, but obviously that just makes it fit really nicely. And this lovely neckline, which is also just really nice with a simple gold chain. So big fan of this. And the final piece I'm sharing with you are these loafers, which I did talk about in the last video, in my last vlog. So these have given me a blister, I'm going to be honest about it obviously, which I kind of expect to an extent with a new loafer or a new brogue. These hurt, like they really rubbed the back of my heels. I'm not giving up on them, I'm going to keep trying to break them in, but I can't give you like a full long-term review on them right now. The blister on my foot's nearly healed. I can't wear them again until it's fully healed because what's the point? They're just going to hurt too much. But they look great. I'm going to show you them on in the mirror in a second. They look so good. I love how chunky they are. They kind of remind me of old school shoes that at the time I would have protested against wearing. But how the times have changed. And yeah, I got them in my normal size. The leather is like really nice and soft. You can kind of see it's already softening in just from one wear. I did walk, like I did a good half an hour walk in them as well. So they hurt, but I probably walked more than I should have done for a first walk. However, long-term review, I will let you know how it goes breaking them in. I really hope it goes well. I also wore them with no socks. So I was asking for it, it's fair to say, but yeah, there's no denying. They really got me. Let me show you them in the mirror. Here we go. Excuse that little, it's one of Luigi's toys, that purple ball. It's tucked under. I think they're so nice. I think they look like they could be a designer shoe as well. They obviously make your feet look massive, but that's what a chunky shoe is all about. And yeah, I really like them. They fit true to size and everything. But yeah, like I said, give me some time to wear these a few more times and break them in and let you know if they get comfier over time. I'll link them in the description box. They do them in another colour as well, but I personally prefer the all black. So yeah, that is everything. Thank you so much, Arquette, for working with me on this. Some really nice pieces. As much as I am not happy that summer has not begun and is already at the end, in terms of the weather we've had here, it's quite nice to be like thinking about jumpers again. We all know how passionately I feel about a navy blue jumper at this stage. Everything will be linked in the description box, like I said, and big thank you to Arquette for working with me as always. Any questions on sizing, whatever, just leave a comment and I'll get back to you. And now I'm gonna change out of this jumper since it's suddenly so hot and the light is all over the show, and empty the dishwasher. What an exciting life. Oh, these are, I'm getting them all sorted, two different sizes, like we said. So these are called the Cambridge White and these are the Artist White. And as you can see, can you see in this light? A bit better if I'm not there. Yeah, I think you can see. This one's a lot more grey and this is a lot more white, which the lady at the company explained is how this batch of tiles goes, because it's meant to be quite rustic looking, which isn't personally what I want. I want something more uniform, I've decided. So they have sent this one, which is just the perfect simple white tile. But also very excitingly, the glass blocks arrived today. This is one of them. It's really weird seeing it for some reason. It's just like a really interesting object in itself. And so it's quite nice being able to see these next to each other like this. I'm gonna hold it up to the light and see what it looks like. 1 second. Just about to go out to the pub and see my friend Emma for a drink as well. Obviously I've got frosted ones, it's going in a bathroom, but so nice. I know these aren't gonna be to everyone, for everyone's taste, because they're kind of very 80s feeling, but I just personally love them and have always loved them. I think they look great. Ideally I would have had clear ones, they're my favourite ones aesthetically, but could you make less of a guest-friendly bathroom than by having a clear wall? Just binning some stale crisps, which have been out on the side for way longer than I care to admit. Luigi's here, of course, and yeah, I am just about to go out to one of my locals, which is really, really, really nice one actually, so I'm really looking forward to meeting my friend Emma for a drink. It's really hot in London. Which is lovely, so nice. We've got 3 days of sunshine, which will be the back end of this vlog, I suppose. I'm just wearing a really old Arquette tank, some black long trousers, which are new, my dear Francis size that I always wear. And I'm just gonna take that mulberry bag, which is called the Sadie. So many of you guys ask questions about this bag. It's such a good bag. What I love is the width of the over the shoulder strap. And then how this looks on the side. Really great, great, great bag. I'll leave a link for it in the description box. So yeah, I'm all ready to go out basically, and I've had such a busy day. Every minute is accounted for at the moment, which is so exciting, but just full on. And yeah, I am really looking forward to having a drink. The other reason every minute is accounted for is because I'm also being very social, which I'm also really enjoying, but inevitably that saying, which mums love to say around the world, you're burning the candle at both ends, is a saying for a reason. You just always get to that point where you just have done too much of both. But at the moment, do you know what? We're young, single, living in London and very much enjoying it all. So why the heck not? I'm gonna go to the pub. Hey guys, ignore the spots that I have not been squeezing because that's naughty. It's Wednesday morning. Just went for a nice long walk. Oh, just sat on something. Just went on a nice long walk and now I'm back home waiting for the mirrors to be delivered. So this is how the vlog will end, you guys seeing the mirrors being put up. They should be here in the next hour. So I'm really excited. It's the ones in the living room and the ones in the in this kind of walkway bit here. So yeah, I can't wait for those to be here. And that is gonna be sort of the last home update for a while. All of the where comes Weege? I wonder what that noise was. You okay? Yeah. It's hot, isn't it, darling? Yeah, it's hot. It's hot, hot, hot. All of the work that's happening on the house starts in a couple of weeks. And my latest bit of news for you all is that I'm actually going to be going away for a while. A lot of that work's being done. There's lots of like really boring things happening to the house, like big parts of the roof need redoing and things like that. So like big structural things which are pretty much making this place unlivable for a few weeks. So I'm embarking on a very big solo adventure, which I will obviously be sharing with you guys. I am starting off in Canada is the first bit. Their borders opened very recently. So yeah, I'm going there by myself for a couple of weeks. and then on to America is the plan. I'm so excited. I'm so excited. Obviously feeling incredibly fortunate to be able to do this. And yeah, by the time we get back, we'll be full steam ahead with all of the house updates and things. There's just going to be like, there's going to be no roof basically for a while. So quite disruptive. But I can't wait. The next video I'm going to do is going to be a packing video because I've never been on a trip this long before. So I thought it'd be kind of interesting to decide what to take, because it would be like a true reflection of my current favourites as well, going into autumn and winter as well. But yeah, I can't wait. I'm kind of at a point in my life where I've never felt this autonomous before and this independent. And the idea of just deciding to go away somewhere, like I said, is not only unbelievably fortunate and privileged, but I just feel really, really lucky and really independent is the best way I can describe it. And I'm just so excited, so excited. And you get to actually go on walks in somewhere new. I know I say stuff like that all the time, but I can't wait, and I can't wait to take you guys along with me as well. So you're gonna have a packing vlog, and then we shall be coming from Canada. Any recommendations for Canada, specifically Vancouver and Toronto, let me know. And yeah, let's see what these mirrors look like, and that is going to be the last house update for a while. And then, like I said, lots and lots coming your way when I'm back. Mirrors are in, guys. Excuse the fact they're dirty and they've still got these on. I can't do anything about that for 24 hours. Ow, I just stood on it. But they're in. This is the exact effect that I was hoping for, where you can just see loads of you going forever on, forever more. But even just this bit here makes this space feel instantly bigger. It's so nice being able to see the light reflected in it. When there's a bookshelf on this wall, which is where there's going to be one, and then that will be reflected in here. And then in the living room, they look just great. So pleased with them. It's made space feel so much bigger. So much bigger. One on each side. Let me just shut this door so I can try and show you them both at once. So yeah, now I've got these up, I feel pretty sure that I want that photo on the wall properly. It's just leaning there, as you can see. I think whether or not this is the living room or the dining room, that will look really nice there. So definitely do that. Now that these are in, I'm so glad I didn't go for the bookshelves on either side, because this has just made the room feel so much bigger and brighter. I think makes the most of how much light comes in from the bay window. What do you think, Weege? New mirrors. Oh, it's so cute. But yeah, so pleased with them. Hello me. Oh, it's all coming together. It's so exciting. I really cannot wait to have the bookshelf up there. I think that's going to make the biggest difference as well. And then when that's up, I'll probably then decide on whether I want this room to actually be the office-y working space or stick to it the way it is. But yeah, can't be happy with these. Oh. So I'm going to end this vlog here. And thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much to Arquette for working with me again. I hope you all enjoyed. And I will see you in the next one, which will be all about packing for a big old trip.